September. Yes. Sir Charles is here in the studio to give that report. Over to you.
Thank you very much, Regina. It is the first trading day for the month, the first trading day for the quarter. And it was a very hot afternoon. Traders were trading from their different locations, different remote locations, because nobody comes to the physical trading floor again, at least since COVID. And at exactly 2:30, when the closing gong sounded, the bears took control slightly. So the ASI, that is the All Share Index, lost 0.09% to close at 39,184.22 basis points. Total volume of shares at exchange hands was 169.3 million units, valued at about 1.42 billion naira in over 3,357 deals. Looking at the sectorial performances today, starting with NGX 30, which is the index that measures the performance of the 30 most capitalized and liquid equity on its platform, also closed in the negative territory, losing 0.07%. The insurance subsector, the banking sector, industrial sector, consumer sector, all closed in the negative territory, losing 0.02%, 0.23%, 0.08%, and of course 0.62% respectively. However, the industrial sector remained flat. Okay, the looking at the gainers chart, leading that chart, it's ICO, the insurance firm, adding 4.04% to close at 1 naira 30 kobo. Closely following ICO is Custodian, adding 3.15% to close at 6 naira 55 kobo. We also have Fitzing Pharmaceutical, adding 7.8% to close at 6 naira 25 kobo. Fidelity Bank also made the list, losing 2.55% to close at 2 naira 41 kobo. There is an unconfirmed report today in the news about Fidelity Bank. I don't know how true it is, but we are going to confirm that they intend to lay off some workers. But I'm sure we are going to confirm that if it is a real news. Livestock also made the list of gainers, adding 0.95% to close at 2 naira 13 kobo. Other companies that made the gainers chart was GT Co, which had 0.37% to close at 27 naira 45 kobo. Moving on straight to the decliners chart, the laggard topping that chart is FTN Cocoa, operating from Oyo State, Ibadan, the capital of Oyo State, losing 8.77% to close at 52 kobo. Closely following FTN Cocoa is Morrison, losing 5.42% to close at 1 naira 92 kobo. We also have UPDC losing 4.84% to close at 1 naira 77 kobo. Jais Bank also made the list, losing 4.76% to close at 60 kobo. We also have one of the oldest banks in the country, Buema Bank, losing 4.65% to close at 82 kobo. Other losers that made that list, we have Nigerian Breweries, which closed at 48 kobo. Like I said, in the news, we are trying to confirm whether Fidelity Bank is actually trying to lay off some workers. But confirm whether it's a genuine, it's a correct news. Yes, but before I close today on this market report, we have to take and do a shout out to somebody.
All right, a shout out to Peace, Miss Peace, Edisemi Fakroha. Yesterday was our birthday. Yes, yesterday was our birthday. We wish you a happy, happy, happy birthday. Many more fruitful years in health and wealth. I hope you had an amazing celebration yesterday.
Yes, and the celebration continues today. So people can still come. It's just 31 Road.
Okay.
Flat 15, Block 1. All first time right. Town. Yes.
Okay. Hope you had an amazing celebration. Yeah. And I hope, this marks the beginning of an amazing year for you. Yes.
Yeah.
Birthdays comes once in a year. That's why I particularly like to celebrate my birthday every year. Even though this year I didn't celebrate it. I did not at all. Because I wasn't feeling too well at that time. Yes. So my mind was all over the place. But, so many things to be grateful for.
Yes,
a lot of things to be grateful for. And I hope you had an amazing birthday celebration yesterday, filled with love, laughter, happiness, with all your loved ones and your family members and your friends. So I'll play this very oldie, old song. I wish you enjoyed this song. If they never play this song for your birthday never comes. It's by Edna Ogolis. Happy birthday. Have a lot. Happy birthday. Peace. Oh,